All right, ladies and gentlemen, y'all already know what time it is, man. If you like the video, subscribe for more daily Call of Duty content. And first of all, we want to say, yes, sir! What's going on, everybody? It's your boy, Jay Eazy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BKA the People's Champ, coming to you live with another video, man. Listen to me, man. Listen to me good. I saw my comments on the Call of Duty thing, man. I know y'all boys liking this dookie. So we're going to bring it to you as long as we can, man. I'm going to try to drop a Call of Duty video every day of the month for the month of January. If we revive Call of Duty in some capacity, then we're going to keep on doing it. If we do not revive the Call of Duty part, then we're just going to forego it. We're going to go back to just straight up 2K. Now, we're going to be dropping 2K gameplays. I think some people thought I was going to stop doing 2K. Never going to stop doing 2K. That's the bread and butter right now. But if Call of Duty, you know, come on up. Hey, man, we might do some Call of Duty. We might go back to playthroughs and all that stuff. I need you guys to tell me what y'all want me to do. If y'all want me to do playthroughs and stuff, let me know what game y'all want me to play through. Y'all want some MW2? Y'all want some Black Ops 1? Y'all want all that stuff, man? Let me know what y'all want to see, man. I'll put it up here. Y'all want Madden, any of that stuff, man? Let me know. Anyway, man, quick video, man. Quick 29 kill gameplay, man. I know we was... I saw a few people talking in the comments yesterday, man, and they were talking about, hey, wait till you get in those sweat lobbies where, you know, guys just sweating their balls off and all this stuff, and then it ain't gonna be too much fun. Let me tell you something, brother. When I get in those games where people play like hoes, and that's what you is, you a bitch if you play like that. I'm just gonna tell you straight up. It ain't no conservativeness. It ain't none of that stuff, man. You play like that, you playing like a straight up bitch. If you play like that, that's always been my stance on it. If you play it conservatively and you want to take it slow and all that stuff and camp and go slowly and progress slowly, that's one thing. But I'm talking about the people that just sit in one spot. Like, if you play like Brute, how Brute controls the area for me and then he goes from end to end in that area, like, that ain't camping to me. I'm talking about camping to me is when people are just literally sitting in one spot in the back of the map, hoping, wishing, and praying for somebody to come over there, you know, and walk by them so they can get a little cheap kill. Now, I'm not gonna lie to y'all. I've been playing this game. That's camping right there. He's not moving at all. He wasn't thinking about moving. He wasn't about to move. He wasn't gonna do nothing. Now, the best weapon in this game to me, man, let me tell y'all real quick, is the Kilo. I got the Kilo with a few things. Look at it get dropped. Drop that bitch from long range. Headshot, get it. Listen. The best weapon in the game to me is Kilo, but right now we playing Hardcore Team Deathmatch. So in Hardcore Team Deathmatch, honestly, my brother, it really don't matter what you're using. You can really use anything you want. Hip fire, you get caught up in it. Hip fire. But look, bro, and that's the one reason I hate playing Hardcore Team Deathmatch right now. I can't care about my damn teammate. But it is what it is. Look, a lot of times when you play this game, man, you're going to run into these lobbies where you don't want to be in. You're going to run into the sweat lobbies. You're going to look, bro, we've been playing Call of Duty for 10 years, over 10 years on this channel. I have nothing to prove anymore. I done dropped kills in the best with the best lobbies. I done played with Fist and NASA one and held my own. I done played against people that are supposed to be good, the ego envies of the world and all that stuff. I done that stuff, man. I got nothing left to prove. If I get into a lobby where I deem the play to be like they just playing like bitches, or if I get Piccadilly Circle, I'm like Coke Gotti, and I'm not gonna play the game because I don't have anything to prove or anything like that. Is it gonna make it hard to get consistent gameplays? Yeah, a little bit, man, but look, I've rotated the games. I've played some Domination. I've played some Hardcore Team Deathmatch. I played Regular Team Deathmatch. I've done it all, man. I just want to play the game and have a good time. And whatever I'm having fun with at the time, that's what I'm going to do. Do I play for gameplay? Nah, man. Gameplay is just really happen naturally. But yes, bad hit detection. Poor player visibility. Watch me do a bank shot. No good. Bad hit detection. Poor player visibility. Awful. Get dropped that bitch from long range. Watch him open the door. You ain't gonna open the door? It is what it is. Poor player visibility. Awful tick rate. All these things. Trash maps. These things are real issues with this game. But when you get on a good map and everything is running the right way, hey, for 4 or 5 games, you're gonna be good, baby. But other than that, I got a condo on my neck, girl. I'm backing out. I'm not going to sit here and play against people that are playing the game a very cheap way. Because it's crazy, right? The people that are sitting there camping and not doing anything, they not getting any kill streaks. They're not doing anything. Like, that dude right there that just headshotted me luckily like that, he ain't getting no kill streaks, man. Look at the score. Like, I do understand that games are going to the time limit and that, you know, I don't know what he was thinking about. Look at that snap-on aim. Snap-on. Snap-off. Snap-on. Snap-off. The snapper. Y'all already know what it is. I'm looking for this dude right here, bro. I don't know. But it seems like in hardcore team death... Yep, he got me. He shot me in the balls. I guess that was a headshot. It seems like in hardcore team deathmatch, man, a lot more people are moving. A lot more people are trying to play the game kind of the right way. And I guess it's just because, you know, with hardcore, you don't have the map like you got a mini map anyway. None of that really matters. But it just feels like that more people are moving. Hip fire. You get caught up in it. Two piece. Three piece. It feels like people are moving more. But if you get in the wrong lobbies, like I said, into the quote unquote sweat lobbies where people don't want to move and don't do that, bro, don't put yourself through this stuff, man. It's all right to back out. Because just like Murder Show say, bro, if everybody, I don't know what he was thinking about. I already had him. Two piece. Bloodthirsty. I'm about to get this last kill back here. I got to make sure I got my stuff. Woo, get dropped. Uh-oh. I see him. I'm about to come for you. Like Murder Show say, bro, ain't nobody finna sit here and fight these people and play these people. Oh, it's prime time. Let's get this here started. PP7 number 6, gotta be extra small. Tell that bad boy in the corner to get from Ronya, cause we are dangerous. Whoa, Harriers, come out and play. Yo, we ain't got nothing to prove, man. Cause like we said, we know that the skill-based matchmaking is to the ceiling in this game. If you do well in one game, you best believe after I played this game and dropped these 29 kills, they put me in the sweatiest of the sweat lobby. I'm talking about kids that hadn't taken showers in 3 weeks since the game, you know, did the new update or whatever, man. Like, they did it. Of course they did that. But look, what you got to realize, what you're doing. You got to see what's going on. Hey, just back out, bro. Ain't no shame in it. I used to be one of them guys that be like, I'll never back out. I'll never lobby surf. I'll never do that just for gameplay or whatever. You know, I used to be that guy. And now I'm just like, bro, I'm not finna sit here and get myself, like dude said, I'm not about to get myself an aneurysm or something like that trying to play this game and prove something that nobody cares about. All y'all want to see is good gameplay. Yes, like I said, there's a lot of problems. You got a good map like Crash. You got to also have a team to run with. Right here, I'm running with T-Mizzle and them guys, too. So I'm probably going to run with them a lot more. You can't really play this game by yourself. You got to have a team that's willing to push the game along and do stuff like that. Because just like the Murder Show say, bro, if everybody camps like a bitch, then you're going to end up with exactly what we have right now. Nobody moving. Games going to the time limit. 7 out of 8 games go to the time limit, at least. Hip fire. Oh, he got me. At least 8 out of 10 games go to the time limit, especially if you're playing by yourself. Like my dog T-Mizzle. T-Mizzle is the most casual Call of Duty player you would ever meet in your life because he don't care about the game. He just want to play, have fun, and get off. And he said, bro, I never in my life have seen so many games of Call of Duty go to the time limit, man. Hey, but look right here. We had 29 kills, man. I don't know how many deaths I had. Maybe 29 kills, maybe 10 deaths, something like that. We're going to see in a second. He said, I've never in my life have seen so many games of Call of Duty go to the time limit. And he is absolutely right. These games should not... Oh, okay, 29 kills, 7 deaths, 4.14 KD, man. Hey, you best believe that they punished me bad. I mean, awfully the next game, man. But, you know, we like I said, hey, it's your boy Jay-Eazy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop. BK the People's Champ coming to you live with the essence of ass waxery, live and direct from the place that we like to respectfully refer to as the Ass Factory. And y'all already know what time it is. Like I said, bro, the game is fun. It could be the best Call of Duty ever. Everything is technically sound. The maps are just awful. I see people looking for ghosts. I see people looking for stuff. If y'all want me to talk about this game and just put other cards gameplays up, let me know which Call of Duties to play down in the comment section. I will play anything. If y'all want walkthroughs back, let me know, bro. I'm gonna try some of everything, man. We're gonna give it our best shot this year. And like I said, if you need something from 2K, let me know. I got another 2K video. I'm probably gonna put a gameplay out like 10 o'clock, something like that, maybe midnight or whatever. Or we might do what we used to do, get up and do early morning Call of Duty. do a 2K gameplay video, news video or something like that in the evening, and then like 12 o'clock we used to come with the game, the play, the walkthroughs, man. What game do we want to walk through? I don't know, man. But like I said, this could be one of the best Call of Duties ever, man. They just need to get their stuff together, man. A lot of times what it is that the people that create the games, they have such high egos. I created something that could not possibly be wrong, be anything wrong with it. And that could be the case. Look, it's just like when a mom has a child and she's like, ain't nothing wrong with my baby. And you like, no, we need to take the baby to the doctor and get seen about because something is wrong with the child. Is this for the child's sake? This is for the good of the colony. This ain't just about you or whatever. But y'all know what it is, man. That's how it is. Imagine that. When somebody try to tell you your kid bad as hell or he doing this or he doing that at school, you'd be like, ain't nothing wrong with my baby. My baby fine. You be ready to fight about that. These developers are largely the same way. This is their baby. So the way that we have to come at them and tell them that this bullshit is garbage, we just got to figure that out, man. I don't know how we're going to do it, but we're going to do it. We're going to figure it out, and we're going to come at them in a way where they can understand and realize that change needs to be made because these trash-ass maps and all these doors and stuff, they are killing the game. And like I said, I'm lobby surfing. It don't bother me. I can back out all day. Even when they try to be at the end of the game, be like, nah, you ain't backing out. Bitch, I turn my PlayStation off. You can't stop me from backing out. But anyway, man, y'all let me know what y'all do. Do y'all lobby surf like me? Or do y'all just ride it out and do like, and you know, do like that? And maybe I'm the bitch for them lobby surfing. Who knows? But hey, you might be right. But guess what? I ain't gonna have no high blood pressure, man. Anyway, I gotta get up out of here, man. Y'all let me know what y'all think down in the comments. Hopefully y'all, and like I said, if you camp, I want you on my team because you're really holding something down and I can move throughout the map and do my thing. You know what I'm talking about? Fellas, I'm ready to get up and do my thing. I can do my thing if you play. It's crazy because I like playing with campers, but I don't like playing against them. And I don't camp myself. But I love my campers now. So if you control areas and you set up and patrol and make it safe for me to come back and forth through, holler at me. Send me an ad on whatever, man. Let's do all this stuff, man. But anyway, I got to get up out of here. I'm about to hit the gym, man. Y'all already see what it is. Work harder, shine brighter. Gym star. I'm holler at y'all next time. Till next time. It's your boy, Jay Easy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ. Godspeed.